Hello, good morning everybody. I'm Yannick Douzan. I'm a product and technology director at Sistran, and I'm here with Alexandra.
Hello everyone, I'm Alexandra Priori. I'm a pre-sales consultant in Sistran.
As an introduction, during this webinar, we'll present our new generation of enterprise server solution, which we call Sistran Pure Neural Server. It is our version 9, and basically it brings a new user interface, extended integrations possibilities through the APIs, and also a brand new generation of transition engines, which are basically better in terms of transition quality and also much faster than the previous one. A quick reminder for those who may not know Sistran. So we are a pure player in machine translation and natural language processing. We are a software vendor, and we do that only. We provide the translation engines and tools for more than 140 language combinations. We are basically 200 employees, dispatched in Seoul, Paris, and San Diego, knowing that the R&D center is mostly in Paris. We have entered a phase when we now share our technology, and we collaborate a lot with the research and academic ecosystem. So we work with the French CNRS, but also with Harvard University and a lot of institutions. And we provide open source our framework, which is called OpenNMT, and which has quite a great success on GitHub. On top of that, we invest more than 25% of our revenue in R&D. What we provide basically is state-of-the-art machine translation technology, and we followed all the trends. We pioneered even most of them, and we have engine in rule-based. We have also hybrid and statistical engine, but more recently we focus on neural machine translation. So let's start with our new Sistran Pure Neural Server, which is the new version of Sistran Enterprise Server. It's also the version 9. For those of you who may know the version 7 or version 8, the upgrade to Sistran Pure Neural Server will bring first a brand new user interface. So we have a new look and feel and also updated technical framework. For better maintainability, but also security. We have a brand new navigation mechanism to optimize the space usage in all screen. Navigation is also better, and we reorganize some menus and features that may seem complex in the past. We also optimized and simplified a lot of screens to display a list of items. So list of dictionaries, the list of various services, the statistics, the user, the roles on the administration screens are now better manageable. And also we simplified the way to deploy a transition engine to create profile for you to use straight away your customized transition. In this new version, we also added some integrations for first translating more formats. So this is integration to convert content into a textual and translatable format, and also to bring translation everywhere through the APIs. The first area in which we improved our connectors is in the speech to text domain. So we added connectors to two speech to text servers. First one being Vocapia, and second one being Nuance Transcription Engine. So the way it works is quite straightforward. You just have to indicate where is your speech to text server. Then, Pure Sistran server will chain the transcription and the translation. On top of that, we added specific tools to adapt to the specific factors of an audio file. As we chain two steps, The transcription and then the translation. We added the possibility first to listen to the audio file and to view the synchronized text on the bottom of the screen and also the translation. The second adaptation is that when you translate a text input, you don't want to modify the source. When you translate an audio input, you may want to correct the transcription and then to retranslate in order to achieve a better result. So we have added the tools to enable you to fix the transcription when you listen to a mistake the transcription engine may have made. You are able to fix it and then to relaunch the translation to improve the overall result. Another integration we added is to enable the translation of non-text content through OCR, optical character recognition, so that you can directly input PDF or PNG or JPEG files. And then the OCR engine connected to the server will give the text, and again, we will give directly the translation. So we have two options so far for the OCR. By default, we partner with Iris company and we embed the Iris IDRS SDK. And also, we have an optional plugin available for ABI FineReader Engine that requires an additional ABI runtime license, but that can be better for some language pair or some specific documents. So this is your choice. And we offer the two possibilities. So this was for the upward integrations. And then we have improved our APIs for you to bring the translation where it needs to be. So our API is RESTful and is fully compliant with OpenAPI, which was a Swagger before, and enables to translate text and files, but also to watch feedback and to manage remotely the translation memories, the corpus, and also the dictionaries. Using this API, we provide built-in or pre-built connectors that we make or that our partners are making, but it is also possible to do and to develop any in-house or ad hoc integrations, whether it is in an intranet or in a specific flow. The API is there and it can bring the translation where it needs to be. So a few examples of integration we made recently. So we added a plugin for Skype for Business that enables to have conversations with two participants, but also group conversations. And the plugin enables each one of the participants to read all the conversation in his own language. So we can imagine that we have a conversation with a French guy, a German guy, a Dutch guy, an English one, and each one of the participants will see the whole conversation translated into his whole language. Just to give you an overview, we have today an integration ecosystem that covers, of course, the Office Microsoft suite and the desktop tools. Let's say Outlook, Excel, Word, PowerPoint, but also the browsers, so that the end users can have the translation directly on their work environment without having to open a browser. But we have also a set of already existing connectors for various CAT tools or translation management systems, for some content management systems, CMS, or marketing documentation tools. We have also some connectors for media monitoring and mining or e-discovery solution, and also some tools and connectors into open source intelligence solutions for mass translate big batches of documents. So let's go on with the really big announcement and big novelty in the SysTrompure neural server new generation. It is our second generation of NMT engines. So in 2016, we were among the first to release the first production-ready NMT engines. At the time, we saw really a better quality. But due to the specificities of neural networks, it was really slower than previous technologies. On our side, the NMT models, they were still running through the historic core engine that we used and developed throughout the years for rule-based and RSMT engines. And we know that the algorithms are evolving. We started with recurrent neural networks. Now we are pushing and using the transformer engines. Some are trying the CNN, the convolutional neural networks. We don't know what will come next, but we needed a new core engine to be able to cope and to adapt with all those changes. So just to sum up this in a picture, what we had in version 8 for the first generation engine was something that was working. As you can see on the left of the screen, but we can imagine that it is not optimal. So what we have now in SysTrompure Neural Server 9 is something that is designed for neural machine translation and that is adapted to provide the best and the optimizations of neural machine translation. So basically, let's go into the technical side. Our new core engine is using at the very heart, in the red part, our OpenNMT framework. We are currently promoting the transformer OpenNMT TF, which is using the transformer algorithm and which provides the best of breed results today. But it is encapsulated with SysTrom modules to do all the technical work before and after the translation. So that is what we call the monolingual pre-process, in which we review the data, we clean it, and we prepare it for the translation. And also during the post-process, in which we set up and we put all the pieces in place. And we have a streamlined mode for translation, meaning that the translation step has been optimized and differentiated from the training step so that in your production environment, the performances are really better. In terms of quality, I put here a few figures of blue score against our test set. So they need to be read carefully, and they are just a score for a given test set. But we can see that we have overall a better quality and fluidity for our generic engines. What is sure is that it outperforms all our previous generations, and it is now comparable or better to generic competition, the online engine. It is our constant objective to have a good engine out of the box. And we have to see that all these generic engines are just a starting point for any further specialization. Meaning that if you have a specific data, a specific domain, we start from our generic engines and then we train them, we specialize them with your data. In terms of performance, I told before that we developed a dedicated mode that was adapted and streamlined for the transition step. This is what we call inference step in the neural network terminology. And basically, for this step, we have removed all the abstractions and the calculations that were needed only when we did the training. This means that the translation engine that you will install on your SysTrom server will be really lighter and won't contain all these useless steps when you just want to translate. We also have introduced some libraries from Intel to optimize the calculations on CPU. And we have developed a quantization algorithm that is meant for reducing the size and the calculation necessary during the transition step. So basically, with a really slight decrease in quality, it enables to streamline the performance and to achieve the figures we can see on the chart, meaning that with NMT V8 version 8 engines, we were at something around 50 to 100 characters per second, and we can achieve on a small CPU with NMT version 9, we can achieve 2000 and even more if we add more CPUs. So on average, we are 15 to 30 times faster than the first generation NMT on CPU and with a reduced memory footprint. So we can say here that we are really better than on the market here, and we have removed this strong limitation of the previous and also of some of our competitors' engines, meaning that we have reduced the hardware prerequisites, and you can now run on your environment neural translation engines without having to spend really a lot of money in the hardware. We also just released, and we are proud of that, the enablement and the use of user dictionary with neural networks. So Sistran, you know that we have a strong history in rule-based, and we have spent 50 years of into developing what we call our coding engine. So we have rules, and we have dictionaries, and we have a legacy of linguistic rules that enables us to be top of the market into dictionary coding, into morphology analysis, into linguistic rules. And we just taught our neural networks to cope with that. It's not so simple, because the specificity of the neural networks is basically to do whatever they want, and sometimes we don't really understand how they achieve a result. But we developed the algorithm to force and the neural networks to apply the terminology, and also it is not just a word matching algorithm. Our neural networks are able to use and to understand all the flexions, all the morphology of a term. This means that as a user, you just have to enter one term. In our example, for instance, we enter the term sentence, which is a noun, and we translate it in French into verdict. And we also enter a verb, two sentences, that we translate in French into condamné. You can see on the screenshot that the coding engine generates all the inflected forms. Here it is a verb, so it will generate and understand the infinitive, but also the various tense, the present, je condamne, tu condamnes, il condamne, and also the past participle. And then the translation engines will be able, in context, to determine the correct part of speech, and also to inflect the words. So you can see in the example that in the first sentence, yes, we have two times the word sentence that appears. The judge didn't hesitate to sentence the accused, and the engine understands that this is a verb. And so he applies the verb entry, and you can see le juge n'a pas hésité à condamner. And you can see at the end of the sentence that this is the noun that is recognized, and the engine will make the difference by itself. You have a second example, and you will see that later in the demo. But this is really a true achievement, and we have introduced morphology and syntactic analysis in neural networks. In terms of language coverage, we have up to date More than 40 transition directions that are already available in this new PN9 generation. You can see the languages, and more are coming. And we have enabled user dictionaries for the most mainstream languages, Chinese, French, German, Japanese, and so on. And we have also more that are coming. And this is quite unique on the market. And to conclude this presentation, with this new generation of engines, we totally reviewed our internal tools and processes to massively produce neural translation engine. Our generic ones, but also specialized ones for you, depending on your needs and on your domain. What we know is that a specialized MT engine will always be better when you know what you have to translate than a generic one. And we have all the tools to do that now and to leverage our generic engines to retrain, to do incremental trainings on top of our generic ones using your data. And you can see that we have a massive improvement in terms of Bleu score when we want to specialize an engine into a specific domain. To do that, we have developed and we are using internally a new tool that we call the infinite training process. And you can see that each one of the engines is actually a sequence of iterations, of epochs. We call that epochs in our jargon. And each one of the epoch is being represented by a bubble. And it's scored against more than 50 test sets so that we can follow and we can evaluate the progression of a given engine into a specific domain. And then we are able to retrieve the distribution of the data that we used for each one of the engines. And we are able to choose a good starting point and to add some incremental trainings using specific data, namely your data to train to your domain, so that we can generate a dedicated and specialized engine that will be best of breed for your specific content and that you can use directly on the Sistran Enterprise server. So basically, that was it. I will let now Alexandra to do a small demo, real time, of all these new features.
Thank you, Yannick, for this presentation. Now that everyone is up to date regarding our technology and our products, I'm going to give you an overview of our new user interface, which is way better and simpler than the previous one, so that you can navigate and translate faster. As you could understand from Yannick's presentation, we have now the best translation quality we ever offer, and this for any content and in any format. And we will end this demo with our new magic feature, the Level 3 User Dictionary for Neural Engines. So, as you can see, I can access my translation server from any browser. It could be even from my smartphone if I wanted to. Here I'm using Firefox, but the browser choice is up to you. Here we are. This is the version 9 new modern user interface, with a brand new look and made of new components to ensure the best performance. We have a new navigation with these tabs for the translation features, and with a left panel menu here to ensure better space utilization and to give more space for user actions and for readability. You can manage all the linguistic parts in the profiles, resources, and feedback section. And all the administration, like user management, user statistics, and translation resources deployment in this lower section. So let's see some examples in the different SaaS features. Here, as in all the different translation features tabs, I select my language pair, and the profile is not displayed anymore, but you can click on the plus symbol to display the different profiles that you have and select one. I click on upload to display the upload file view. And from here, I can select any file from my computer in a lot of different formats. I select here, but I can even drag and drop my file. Of course, I can select files at the same time and from different formats. Here I have an Excel file, a Word file, and a PDF file. I upload them. And now they appear in the queue. And we have a new list view that enables bulk action. So it's great. The new generation of engine enables a very fast translation. That's why I already have my translation here that I can download. If I open the source file, and I show them. I can see that I have specific layouts and fonts for all of them with images, formulas, tables. And of course, I want to preserve all these specificities in my translation. Let's see. As you can see, we keep all the specificities of the table with the colors, the figures, the text, but it's translated. And in a very fast way. Okay, my formulas, great. Okay. We have the same view for the speech translation tab, except that here you upload audio files. And once your file is translated, you can follow the translation with the audio file in the edition view.
Correspondant régional dans les Balkans, comment va se dérouler cette opération en Croatie?
Alors, eh bien, cette opération qui porte le joli nom de Nouveau Départ était à la base une promesse électorale des sociaux-démocrates sortants, parce que la Croatie vient d'élire son président et mais aussi devrait changer de parlement et de gouvernement cette année. Et bien que ce gouvernement soit en mauvaise portuse, il a décidé de tenir sa promesse et il faut dire, c'est à la surprise de tous, y compris
right. As you can see, the tool can follow the text while the speaker is on. Next, I want to talk about web translation. So we have this tab in which you can copy paste the link of the web page you want to translate. But you can choose my favorite option, which is CTrans Browser Extension. For example, here I'm on a Korean web page. I see novel, but I don't understand a word of what is written here because I don't speak a word of Korean. Fortunately, I have my CTrans Browser Extension here. It's very, very simple to install. You just need to specify the link of your CTrans server and your personal API key to have access to all your language pairs and your associated profiles. So here I have my Korean profile. I want to navigate in the website, so I just turn on this option. And I get instant translation. And I can go in another page. And read other articles. And of course, with the new generation of engine, it's very, very fast. So last point, but not least, what if I'd like to customize my neural MT, not only by pattern matching and not only nouns, but with a real dictionary with adjectives, nouns, verbs, that inflects, and with a translation that adapts to the number and the gender of my dictionary entry. Sounds good, right? So let's pick up a sentence, a very simple sentence with a noun and a verb. For example, I drive my car. All right, we have conduire for drive and voiture for car. And now just let's pick up a dictionary, an empty dictionary that I prepared for you. And let's have the word. Let's say I want these translations in my specific context. Okay, my words I replace. Let's try to change a little bit my sentence. See if this works. Okay, I can see here that my engine learns how to manage the dictionary entry. This is an amazing feature, and I'm eager to have new ones like this. So my question here is for Yannick. Do you have any other feature like this for the coming months or years? What are the next steps for Sistrans General Server?
Well, thank you, Alexandra. So all we just showed and talked about is already available, and you can contact us or our sales or pre-sales team, and they will be delighted to analyze and study your project with you. On the R&D side, we are currently working, and you will see in the next couple of weeks or months for some of the features. We work on further user interface improvements. You will get in the 9.3 version, so the very next one, a brand new text transition box, which will be more reactive and which will provide more alternatives options for the end users to get the most of our transition tools. And also, we are going even further into the simplification of profile and transition resources management. Basically, in the next version, it will take one click and 20 seconds to deploy a newly released transition engine, and without the harassment of any IT skills, you won't have to set up new machine or to configure master and host and so on. You just have to click on create a profile, and the translation is rightly available for your end users. In parallel, we continuously develop our language pair catalog. So far we have 40 transition engines available for PN9 generation. We have also 12 IT domain engines that you can test. We will continuously release a new language pair to cover all our catalog, and also expand the user dictionary compatible engines, so that all the language directions for which we have transition resources, basically all our rule-based catalog, will be available in PN9 generation with user dictionary support. And last but not least, we are also currently working on performances. We want continuously to improve the performances and the scalability of the solution, so that it can be deployed into any environment for any use case. And we will release soon a GPU dedicated inference mode, which will be 5 to 10 times faster than our CPU mode, which is already the fastest on the market. And also, we are working on optimizing the file translation process, which can be today sometimes quite long for very big files or very big PDFs. So we are working on that. So we have a lot of other issues and details we are working on. But basically, these are the three main areas in which you will see improvements in the next couple of weeks.
All right, thank you. Time for questions, I guess.
Yes. So let me check the question we got during the session. We have a first question about the cleaning of transcription error. So we talked about our new integration with a transcription engine, speech to text. Is it manually or automatically done? What we provide here is Sistrans speaking. It's just connectors to speech to text solutions, and we provide a way for the user to manually fix the transcription so that the translation is better at the end. We don't have any yet any automatic way to fix transcription, but we know that our partners in speech to text engines, they provide a way to customize also their acoustic engines into a specific domain, into a specific file format or file quality, so that you can chain a specialized transcription engine and a specialized transcription engine adapted to the use case. So I hope this answers the question. We have a lot of questions about dictionaries. First one, yes, it can be created by directly by the customer teams. It doesn't require any specific linguistic or technical skills to add a dictionary. Alexandra showed that real time. You can even import some files directly from your term base, whether it is Excel dictionary or textual dictionaries or tabulae separated files. And we have also a mode that enables us to just add terms and the part of speech, so the fact that it is a noun, a verb, or an adjective, will be automatically detected by the coding engine. So if you already have glossaries or term base available, they can be in 5 minutes imported and improve the quality of our generic engines. Okay, so we have another question about what type of data is required for specialization. So of course, the more the better, as usual. But as we do incremental trainings, the quantity of data is less than before for obtaining good results. I will let Alexandra answer that maybe later. But the data we need, the best is to have aligned and clean transition memories. And a good quality and a substantial quantity. But if you don't have that, it's not always possible. We can also generate that data for you by aligning documents or cleaning up the translation you may have. Or we can also search from a specific in-domain corpus that will improve the translation quality of your engine. I don't know if you want to add something on that, Alexandra.
Yes, about the quantity, we usually start from 50K translation units to get a relevant training, because below this number of translation units, the training wouldn't have enough impact on the translation quality.
Thank you. Okay, so we have another question about real-time voice translation. So this is a question we have more and more often today, and the short answer is no. So far, we don't have the real-time translation option. We just are able to translate recorded files that are in a MP3 or a WAVE format. So this is today. Then I know from a Nuance roadmap that they are working on what they call a streaming mode, meaning that you speak into the mic, and the transcription is generated almost real time. And so in the near future, we will be able to integrate that mode so that we can directly translate what is streamed to the transcription engine. But this is not today. Also, I have to say, but this is my personal view, that the we hear a lot of noise and marketing press release on that over the month, but the real user experience is today always quite deceptive. Meaning the chaining of these new two technologies, the real-time transcription and then the translation, may be not mature yet. It is a matter of time, it will come, but we are working on it. Okay, we have another question about a connector. So, namely, is it possible to integrate Sistran with CAD tools such as Trados or XDM? Yes, we have already existing connectors or plugins with most of the CAD tools of the market. So, namely, Trados, we have one, but also XDM, MemoQ, or SDL World Server, or SDL TMS. And if we don't have a connector for a specific tool, there is always the possibility to add one thanks to the API. Okay, so we have an interesting question which asks, can I buy an engine and train it with my own data? So today, the training process is restricted or reserved to our internal teams, so that they can use our tools and to build a specialized engine on top of our generic ones. What we are working on and what we plan to do is to release those features that we use internally to the market, so that in the near future you will be able to train your own engines on top of our generic ones or on top of our any engines and using your own data. So we are currently working on that in order to open our internal tools and to make them a product. But it's not ready yet, but it will come in a near future. Okay, so we have a question about the technology used in our new engines. So the new server, the version 9, can run all our generations of engines. So you can choose to run even an old rule-based engine if you think it is more adapted to your use case. You can choose to run an NMT version 8 that we are using the Torch implementation of OpenNMT, or you can run the latest generation that are based on the transformer technology, transformer algorithm, and using OpenNMT TF, which is a TensorFlow implementation of OpenNMT. Shortly, the difference between OpenNMT TF and OpenNMT Classic, they are of two kinds. First, TensorFlow is a framework that is much more suited and developed and think with production in mind. Meaning that while Torch was more dedicated to scientists and experimentation, TensorFlow is much more robust and adapted to production environment. And then concerning the neural network algorithm, it is based on transformer algorithm, which basically put more emphasis on the context and the attention on the different parts of a sentence during translation, meaning that the quality and the results are much more fluent and aware of the whole sentence during the translation. So the long name of the algorithm is a self-attentional transformer, meaning that the neural network trained using this technology are focusing more on each part of the sentence placing their attention and are aware of the whole context of the sentence compared to the recurrent neural networks that were reading the sentence more sequentially. So basically, this is the reason why the translation gives a better impression of fluidity and quality. Okay. We have a question about quantity. Did you say 50K? Yes, this is the minimum threshold. So we have a question about the quantity of translation units needed for training.
Retraining. Actually.
Retraining. Yeah. And did you say it's 50K?
Yeah.
Yeah. So 50K as the minimum 50K translation unit. Is it enough? If you choose the good starting point and if those 50K translation units are really in domain and containing the vocabulary you want the engine to specialize on, yes, you can see a good improvement with this quantity.
Of course, it will be better with several hundreds of thousand translation units, but we take this as a minimum.
Okay. So we have some question about training experience or really advanced term extraction and so on. So I suggest that you take contact with our technical team so that we can investigate in more details your specific needs. I have also a question on how do I get an access to the demo on pureneuralserver.mysystron.com. So what are the steps to?
Pure Neural Server is our demo server. So to get access to this server, you should contact whether a sales person or a technical. If you already have a contact with Citroën, you can contact the consultant with who you are in contact with. But there are sales that will contact you after the webinar, so we will be in touch.
Okay. Well, I think we covered most of the question and time is getting fast, and so we are over our presentation. Thank you, everybody, for listening to us. Should you have any question or any translation project that could be covered by our solutions, please do not hesitate to contact directly our teams, whether through our website or directly if you have already a Citroën representative, and they will be happy to organize more advanced sessions with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone.